Swahili words, connectors or conjunctions. Hello dears, welcome again to another session of learning Swahili language. Today we are going to look at conjunctions or words connectors. Please welcome and enjoy the lesson. These are some of the words that we are going to see today. Swahili words connectors or conjunctions are words that connect parts of sentences, words, phrases, and clauses. In today's lesson, we are going to look at the list of 40 most common Swahili words connectors or conjunctions. We will also look at how all these connectors are used in sentences and phrases. The following is a list of the conjunctions and their translation in English. Number one, we have this conjunction, ama dash dash au, which means either dash dash or in English. Number two, we have au dash dash au, which can be translated as either dash dash or in English. Then we have au at number three, which means or. Bado is number four, it means still. And number five is bali. Bali means but, or on the contrary, or rather. Number six is endapo, meaning if or in case. We are continuing with number seven, hali means while or since. Huku is meanwhile. Ijapokuwa or japokuwa, meaning even though or although. Ikiwa in Swahili can be translated as if or in case in English. Then we have ila at number 11, which means except or but. And number 12, the conjunction ili means so that or in order that. Number 13, we have conjunction ingawa. Ingawa means although or even though. Then we have isipokuwa, which means except or unless. And number 15 is isitoshe, meaning moreover or furthermore. Number 16, iwapo. Iwapo means if or in case. Number 17, juu ya hapo, means in addition, furthermore or besides. And at number 18, we have kama. Kama means if or like or as or whether. Then we have kama kwamba, meaning as if. This can also be kana kwamba, also mean as if. Then kusudi is for the purpose of. And we have kuwa at number 22, which means that. And number 3 is kwa ajili hiyo or kwa ajili ya hayo, which can be translated as therefore, consequently, or for this reason. Then we have kwa mfano as number 24, and kwa mfano in Swahili means for example in English. Number 25, kwa sababu hiyo is for this reason. Kwa sababu hizo is for these reasons. Kwamba means that. Lakini is but or however. And 29 is maadam. Maadam is provided that or since. And number 30, we have conjunction na, Na means and or with. Then you have number 31, the Swahili conjunction ndio maana, and the English meaning is that is why. Number 32, ndio sababu, meaning that is the reason. Number 33, pamoja na hayo, means besides that. Number 34, kwa hiyo is therefore. Number 35, pia can also mean can mean also, to, or as well. And number 36 is tena. Tena is again, besides, or furthermore. We have number 37, wala. Wala, when is used in a sentence, it means nor or nor dash dash neither. Then we have yani. Yani means that is, I mean, that is to say. So all these three meanings means yani. Zaidi ya hapo is moreover, and ukiondoa hiyo is besides that. You may notice there are some conjunctions that look different but have the same meaning with others. They are used interchangeably. Now, let us see some examples of how these conjunctions are used in sentences, phrases, and clauses. Number one, ninawapenda baba na mama yangu. In English is, I love my father and my mother. So, conjunction here is the word na, which means and in English. Then, we have another example. Marafiki zangu watakuja tena kesho. My friends will come again tomorrow. So the conjunction here is tena or again. Mlima Kilimanjaro ni mrefu, yaani ni mrefu kuliko yote Afrika. This sentence means Mount Kilimanjaro is very high, that is, it is the highest mountain in Africa. Sipendi kunywa uji wala kahawa. This sentence can be translated as, I don't like to drink neither porridge nor tea. So, with the above sentence, Mlima Kilimanjaro ni mrefu, yaani is the conjunction which means that is. And sipendi kunywa uji wala kahawa, wala is the conjunctions. And it means neither, dash dash, nor. Anafanya kazi kama mchwa. He is working like a terminate. So the conjunction here is kama and like. Alikuwa akiendesha gari huku akinywa bia. He was driving the car while drinking beer. Endapo mvua itanyesha, nitapanda mbegu. This is another example for a sentence. Endapo mvua itanyesha, nitapanda mbegu means if it rains, I will plant my seeds. So, endapo here and if are the same thing. Wageni watafika leo ama kesho. The visitors will arrive either today or tomorrow. Then you have another example. Madam, mmesema hamli ugali, nitapika wali. Then the translation of it is, since you is the plural here, have said that you can't eat ugali, I will cook rice. Lugha ya taifa ya Tanzania ni Kiswahili. Kwa sababu hiyo, Watanzania wengi wanazungumza lugha hiyo. The translation of this sentence is, the national language of Tanzania is Swahili. For that reason, many Tanzanians can speak the language. Now we come to exercise. Translate the following sentences into Swahili. Number one, they speak neither French nor English. They speak neither French nor English. Then, I have a headache. For this reason, I cannot go to work. I have a headache. For this reason, I cannot go to work. Number three, although I am very old, I can walk 20 kilometers. And that is the end of today's session. Thank you very much for watching. Please share to others so that we can learn together.